our electric bill be this high? Our division VP says that we're going to double the size of the plant, but our expenses just keep going up. And with the new addition, the expenses will literally go through the roof. Do we even know we have the electrical capacity to supply all that power? Eaton said they can help us by analyzing our power system. But how are they going to find savings on this bill that aren't obvious to us? I mean, I do have an accounting degree, and all these numbers add up, but I just don't know what some of these items are. What the heck is KVA, PF, and KVARH? I know we hired Eaton to do a short circuit and arc flash study for us, but I don't think they're talking about those types of studies, are they?
When you're making additions or changes to your power system, it's very important to know if you're going to run into issues before they happen. In this video, we'll discuss several power system studies that can help you with design considerations and real savings on your power bill. These studies include load flow, power factor correction, and harmonic analysis. You can learn more about these studies and Eaton's power systems engineers here at the Power Systems Experience Center. A load flow study is the first step in analyzing your system from the capacity standpoint to see if your cables, transformers, and generation sources match your intended loads. In addition, a load flow study will point out locations in your system where low voltage or high voltage conditions may exist. Finally, a power factor study may indicate where capacitor banks are required to stay within the limits of your utility contract. The first step in a load flow study is to create an accurate system model and single line diagram. From there, today's computer programs can run simulations of that power system to evaluate what-if scenarios for load changes and contingent situations. The iterative process of a load flow simulation starts by using the load as a known quantity. But since current flow is likely based on voltage, and since the voltage at a particular node varies based on current flow, the program needs to make an educated guess as to the total power flowing from the source. Then calculations are performed until the mismatch of the estimation is very close to the actual load specified. This process used to take many hours for large systems, but for today's computer power, programs like SIME or SKM typically solve the load flow in just a few seconds. Once the load flow simulation is solved, losses and voltage changes along the way are plotted on a single line diagram. This study also reports KW, KVAR, and KVA power flow numbers at each bus, so the power factor at various locations throughout the system can be determined and capacitor sizing and placement can be evaluated. The benefit of this study is that if you intend to increase the size of your facility, you can start with the base case model of the system today and create scenarios to determine if new equipment is needed or maybe only transformer taps need to be adjusted to compensate for the additional load. Many alternative scenarios can be run until you're comfortable with the results. At the end of this process, you'll know exactly the required changes needed to optimize power flow and cost. Similar to any power system study, the model is only as accurate as the input data. After all, as they say, garbage in equals garbage out, if you're not careful. A base case load flow study is a precursor for a number of other power system studies, including motor starting, power factor correction, and harmonic analysis. So it is very important that this model be as accurate as possible. Using the load flow model as a base case, a power factor correction study can be done to determine where capacitors or other power factor correction could be applied. Optimizing reactive current flow by correcting the power factor can save you money. The benefits of power factor correction studies are twofold. First, they can show you ways to reduce your energy bill. For large commercial or industrial customers, utilities often impose a power factor penalty on a bill. This may be a simple multiplier or a very complex calculation, depending on the utility. There are almost as many types of power factor correction penalties as there are utility companies, but the payback may be as short as a few months. Secondly, it can show you how to add more load to your existing system. For capacity reasons or voltage drop considerations, power factor correction equipment is strategically placed throughout a power system. The payback on this scenario is that you don't have to upgrade existing transformers, circuit breakers, and cables to accommodate new loads. With a power factor correction study, you can determine the size of the capacitors and the optimal location to place them so that they'll either eliminate the power factor penalty from your bill or improve the capacity of your power system while improving voltage levels throughout the system. 25 years ago, this would have been the end of the analysis. However, with today's modern electronic loads, one more step must be taken to ensure that the capacitors you select will survive in the power system with harmonics. That is a harmonics study. A harmonic study is a computer simulation of a power system to evaluate voltage and current distortion at various points in the system. It is very similar to a load flow study, but it begins with the known sources being replaced with constant current sources of harmonics. These harmonic sources are placed at each load location, or they can be placed at various other injection points throughout the system, say 10 amps of fifth harmonic and 4 amps of seventh harmonic added to a particular bus. A standard load flow study uses one source of voltage and power, typically the utility or a generator, or a couple of power sources in parallel. Likewise, a harmonic study first uses the same standard load flow analysis to determine the base case 60 Hertz load flow, and then superimposes single or multiple harmonic current injection sources at the specific points throughout the system. This points out that the load flow study is a prerequisite for a harmonic study. This harmonic study will show how harmonic currents flow through multiple parallel and series paths according to the impedance, and the result is a corresponding harmonic voltage drop at various buses in the system. Essentially, it is a load flow starting at the loads and flowing back towards the source, exactly opposite of the traditional analysis. This is done for every harmonic order, 3rd, 5th, 19th, etc., that exists on the system. Harmonic analysis can be very complicated with hundreds or even thousands of buses, or maybe simplified if you just want to determine if the IEEE 519 harmonic limits at the point of common coupling with utility are being exceeded. In the case where power factor correction capacitors are applied, a harmonic study is very important to evaluate scenarios where harmonic resonance may occur. Harmonic resonance will disrupt the normal flow of harmonic current and may cause an amplification situation where 10 amps of fifth harmonic may become amplified to 500 amps of fifth harmonic, damaging capacitors, clearing fuses, or causing other issues in the system. Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we can help you determine if a load flow, power factor correction, or harmonic study is appropriate for your system. We can connect you with our Power Systems Engineering Group to help you save money and optimize your system, ultimately determining the best course of action for analyzing your power system. Contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today and learn more about our Power Systems Engineering Group.